Hey family, what's going on? Welcome back to K&A's Family Homestead, here with another beautiful day. And on top of that, we're going to be doing a DIY project with a ventilation system. Yes, our rabbits right now are in the need for some good ventilation and get some good airflow. So that's what we're going to do. And on top of that, I want to talk a little bit more about the importance of ventilation for your rabbits. Not having a well-ventilated area for your rabbits can cause a long-term problem, such as different bacterias that they get from the smell from the urine and their feces. It actually gives off like an ammonia smell, which definitely causes a lot of problems for bunnies. Some of the examples would be like sniffles. Sniffles, believe it or not, is discharge coming out of their nose, and that can actually last for a while. You can get it treated from a vet, or over time, giving them a good diet, healthy diet, keeping them well ventilated, over time, it can cure. But a lot of times, you have to go to a vet and get it treated. Another example would be the runny eyes. They, because the ammonia is so strong, it will give them a watery, teary eye, and definitely causes irritation from the smell. And most times to fix that is also medicated drops that you put in their eyes. All animals need well ventilations. Now, for the rabbits, their urine smell is a high potency where it really, really, really causes a lot of damage, causes a lot of bacteria, and it's just not good. So I do have a ventilation system here set up that I did myself, and it's just not big enough. It's not kicking as much as it's supposed to outside. So I had to go bigger and better. So hopefully this works. Now what I'm about to show you guys, it's not made for this here, but it definitely, definitely will do the job. Yes, one of these covers 3,000 square feet in a room that's only 150 square feet. So it's definitely, definitely overkill, but I love my rabbits that much that they deserve it. So let's jump into the DIY, show you how I set it up in the rabbitry. Not the attic. Let's go.
I can feel the heat is rising, and that beat is hypnotizing. Oh, oh, no, we run the show. Let's get louder. Come.
All right, there you go. I moved it from the wall. You can actually go in the back and get to the wall clearly, which is awesome. I measured from one end to the other is about 8 feet. And once I get up there, it's not exactly gonna be 8 feet when I get up there. I gotta find the stud. And once I find the stud, then throw some headers, square it off for the vent. All right, so the vent itself is about 15, actually has a plywood. And what I did was I measured 20 inches from length and width. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go and cut that out. And then we're gonna take this bad boy out the box, put it there, we're gonna circle it and get the right dimensions for the vent itself and be able to mount it on this plywood. So
Let's get Let's some sun, it. Baby, it's time to go. All we need to put on is the radio. I can feel the heat is rising, and that beat is hypnotizing. Oh, oh, no, we run the show. Let's get louder, come on, lose control. Got to live or we get too old. Come on, shine, shine a little tonight. Let's get louder, come on, lose control. Ain't no limit while we go for bold. We can shine, shine a little tonight.
All right. Comes with a thermostat. Okay. Wires black and white. Then you got your ground that's in there. And yeah, play disco space outside. This is what we'll be seeing. So yeah, got two. So I'm gonna go ahead and circle. Hopefully I do a perfect circle. Circle. Nah, something's wrong with me. Okay. Okay. Perfect. Perfect. These come with the brackets. Comes with the brackets and screws. Okay, you got two holes here, two holes for the bracket, and I'm assuming the three holes go on the base. So I'm gonna go ahead put this off to the side, make the hole, and then put the brackets on this here, and then fasten it. I'll do that.
Yeah.
Feel the music, the rhythm, a heart on a mission. Can't fight the feeling, and I'm not denying it, no. I'm here to lose all control. Got emotions, yeah, yeah. Emotion, they all wanna go dance. Sweat yeah, in yeah, an yeah. Ocean, and I'm not denying it, no. Yeah, yeah. I'm here to lose all control. Yeah.
Back for the fill up. Man, was it hard? It's like, you know, when you're looking for something, you know it's there, but still can't find it.
Yeah.
I just had that little problem real quick.
Feel the music, the rhythm, a heart on a mission.
It's a short screw and a lock nut.
I'm here to lose all control. Emotions, emotion, they all wanna go dance. Sweat in an ocean, and I'm not denying it, no. I'm here to lose all control. First time on the floor, but I'm into it. Nervous from my knees to my fingertips. I might have a broken heart, but I won't hold back. Lights go out.
nice and centered. I'm gonna go ahead and get some screws and get those bad boys screwed in. All right, one thing I noticed, guys, I'm using a 1 inch to be able to fasten this down, but the board I have is 5/8, so it's gonna stick out a little bit. So what I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna go ahead and grab a 1x3, I believe, and I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna tilt it here from corner to corner just to give it that little breathing room in the middle here. You see that? Give it a little breathing room. I read the directions, this actually says 2 inches. So with that 1x, should give it about 2 inches. And then plus, it'll definitely take the screws, no problem. So let's go ahead and do that real quick.
To put on is the radio. I can feel the heat is rising, and that beat is hypnotizing. Oh, no, we run the show. Let's get louder, come on, lose control. Got to live or we get too old. Come on, shine.
Alright, so what I'm going to do right now is I'm looking for a stud. So I did find a stud. By drilling the hole exactly right where the mark is. Now you guys are probably wondering why I didn't use the stud finder. This wall right here is not sheetrock. It's actually solid composite wood. So if I would use a stud finder, it would go off as soon as I put it on and it wouldn't find no studs because this is solid wood. So that's the reason why I did the drilling, just to find the stud to see where I'm at, just in case you wanted to know.
I can feel the heat is rising, and that beat is hypnotizing. No, we run the show. Let's get louder, come on, lose control. Got to live or we get to. Come on, shine, shine a little tonight. Let's get louder, come on, lose control. Ain't no limit while we go football. We can shine, shine a little tonight. Shine a little tonight.
All right, guys, well, there you have it. It was pretty hard doing it by myself, but wind up getting it up there. Now I'm getting to the wiring. I'm not an electrician, but I do have a little trick that I'm gonna use that's not gonna, burn anything down. So let me go ahead and show you. All right, guys, well, this here is a 16 gauge wire. The lowest gauge you can probably go with this is
believe, 14. But definitely this is a lot thicker than what it's calling for. It's an extension cord, 10 feet extension cord. So this here, when I cut it off, it's pretty much gonna have same existing wires here. So let me go ahead, make sure I'm clear on the other end. Okay. Let me go ahead and show you. Here you go, as common, the power, and the ground. That's all I need. All right, guys, despite the mess, it's working. I already feel a total change. It's a lot cooler. All the humidity, all the heat is just going right outside. Now, what I didn't film was the outside, making the hole on the outside, and I also got a vent that it closes and opens as the fan turns on and off. So whenever it does shut off, it closes the vents. So let me show you outside. All right, guys, there it is. Here goes the vent I installed on the outside. Pretty much made the same hole as what you've seen in the inside, and just put a self-operating vent that closes and open as the fan turns on and off. Definitely well put together. 3,000 feet in a room of 150-ish. Definitely gonna do the job, and it's already, I can already feel the difference. So I'm happy, I'm pleased with that. It is not as loud, you hear it. It's not loud at all, which is awesome. Now, I'm gonna probably do something with that vent up there, clean it out, and possibly switch it around. Switch it around where on this side, I'll blow some air in and into the room. And, yeah, that'll just circulate, get some good fresh air in here. Wow, definitely a big difference. So hey, it's what I wanted, and I definitely give you an update after I finish cleaning this all up, cleaning these cages up pretty good. Hopefully that bad boy right there does some justice. All right, guys, well, I hope this helps you. Definitely, if you have any bunnies or any animals at all, please keep them well ventilated. It'll help them with their health, their immune system, everything, the sniffles. It'll just help them. It'll give them a good condition all around. And yeah, what else can you say? This bad boy is definitely gonna do that. All right, well, till next time, guys. Take care. God bless. And I'll see you next time.